Hello and good evening, and welcome back to another episode of Kyle spent too much time fucking with his sound setup, and now here he is recording a podcast on a completely untested, you know, new audio interface.
Yep.
How this
welcome to the pill stream, everybody.
Are far beyond me, but we shall see.
Welcome to the pill stream. We're going to take all these different colorful pills before your very eyes, and we're going to review them based off of the color, the taste, and the texture of it. This episode is brought to you by Blue Chew. That'll be the first pill that we take today.
Blue Chew.
I have to say I'm not taking any of these pills.
So for legal purposes, yes, this is all just a show. So we have the pills out in front of us right now. We're all going to take them at the same time, all right? On count three, all right?
Oh, dear Christ. Okay.
You guys got ready pills in hand?
There's a chase for it. Give me a sec.
All right, one, two, three. Let's do it.
Tastes like Miller Lite. What's up?
This man is mixing his blue chew with the Miller.
The red one or the blue one?
Red pill or blue pill?
Yeah.
I'll take both and make them purple.
Take the blue pill. You'll vote for an all blue ballot come 2024.
Let's see.
Take the red pill and you'll subscribe to Ethan Ralph on the pill stream.
Give me one second. Get some thematic music going here, as we usually do for these sorts
Sean,
of episodes.
Sean, as it turns out, that man is a free man.
Mentioned.
Yeah, Ethan Ralph did not get on the plane. He was too inebriated to get on the plane to San Diego.
Amazing.
He doesn't have the money for Xanax anymore. He's taking Benadryl that he stole from the Mexican Walgreens.
Amazing.
Yeah.
That's kind of hysterical.
You're too poor to afford the drugs that you ruined your family over.
So you had to find a new way to do it.
Yeah. Shit. Find a new way. Instead, you take a box of Benadryl, you take all 12 capsules at the same time, and then you start a live stream with that.
Yeah, I mean, if it works, it works, you know?
Let's see. Well, if Morpheus came up to you and said red pill or blue pill, and he pulled up the Viagra for the blue pill.
I mean...
There it is.
Okay, so... Back on track, what do we remember from last session?
I fucking kicked your ass, Ryan. That's what happened last session.
That is true.
Yeah. Hey. If I had my gifts and my weapons, you would have never been able to fight a girl.
You lost a fight to a girl. There's no way of recovering that armor now.
I don't know what you're talking about. It's an honor to lose to a Wendigo.
I don't know what the fuck you're talking about.
Yeah. I'm gonna quote the Lorax. That's a woman?
Yeah, that's a woman right there.
Okay, we came to the valley, to the lupus cairn. Yeah. We chill out, most of us. No, not in the road. She doesn't chill.
Nope.
Then, little shenanigans. We found the dead cup, which was the black spiral doing, and then we participated in the challenge of the right to become alpha of this mess of a pack.
Well, yeah, we've begun the challenge, and now we are slowly drawing nearer to the final round of this challenge. And we stand in the midst of the valley, wherever the fuck. Oh wow, they changed this a lot. Okay.
Roll 20?
Yeah, they changed Roll 20 a lot.
Had updated again.
Over in, I believe, Forest Generic is where we were at.
Yeah, they implemented brand new sheets for classic World of Darkness.
Did they really?
Yeah, Jay Starks told me about it. Who the fuck is this? This ain't me. That's me. There he is.
That is you.
There it is.
Okay. So. Here we are. In the midst of nowhere. Outside of the Monongahela Valley Cairn, and we stand with the Wendigo on one side and the Geta Femoris on the other. I'm actually going to backtrack a little bit before we get to the challenge, because Siddhartha, there is something I wanted to do with you before the trial, and if you'll forgive me, we can go back and do that real quick.
Good thing.
So, back over at Monongahela Valley, let me get some music going. Give me one moment to
get some epic music.
Yeah, so let me... Where the hell is it? This one here. Copy that. Put it in the thing.
How could it be? Somebody took my boy from me.
Once it starts playing,
my best friend's gone and I'm so alone.
Siddhartha, yesterday when Ends the Road started hounding Jennifer into a fight, you saw this Octenna over here come to the rescue as he chewed up some herbs that he had found there in the brush and used them in order to restore Ends the Road. He himself is a very talented Theurge, and it might behoove you to become this, to learn something from him. He seems a wise individual.
Okay.
Up here on the ridge is his den, so to speak, where he has small collections of herbs all scattered about his den. You have been introduced to him earlier as Elk Antler Licks the Wounds. He is Nocturnal Lupus.
I'll approach him and just kind of, I couldn't help but notice you using some healing herbs earlier before.
That's right. It is only what Mother Gaia gives us. I have only so much gnosis to spend, as we all do. It is good to find other remedies should the need arise.
Of course, of course. It's very smart.
He narrows up his gaze at you, noticing, and trails around you, gets a whiff of your scent gland.
Another lupus. And, if I'm not mistaken, another born under the half moon. Pleasant to see another talented Theurge amongst such an unruly pack, if you'll pardon me.
They are a rambunctious bunch, yes?
No matter. I assume as the Pack Theurge that you know Mother's Touch, correct?
I believe I do. Do I? Hold on. I think I took it. Why is my sheet not opening?
I do not know. Is Roll 20 being shitty again?
See, don't you worry about it. Don't you worry about that sheet.
Hold on, I'm reloading it.
Dug it.
Some weird ass shit I'm getting generated.
Pretty sure I did take it, but let me double check.
It is
what kind of gift you got? Yeah, think about this.
What kind of gifts be there? Well, actually, I can open up your sheet as well.
What kind of head you got in your bed? This
Storm's Merits. Here, Mother's Touch. Yes, I do have it.
All right. I see. Now, like I've said, we both have limited gnosis. But in the event that some injuries could appear, you might not be able to heal. It's good to have an eye for herbs. And he sifts through his piles of leaves all around, and he will go over and explain a number of things that you can use. Here, I have mint and aloe that I have gathered. How you apply these is you would gather the herbs necessary, chew them up, and then apply them to the wound with your tongue. Licking the wounds with these herbs will help you heal certain types of damage much faster than simply licking them would. It's a trick I learned from many years. Here is the very beginning of a list of collectibles that you may encounter throughout the session. Talking to Elk Antler or other Theurges who have heard of him will give you recipes in order to let you craft more herbs that you may use to better heal certain types of damage. As you can see, mint bone, you'll require mint and aloe, and will heal fire damage equal to wits and medicine. Luna leaf heals damage from silver equal to wits and medicine, which requires echinacea and aragonum. And mother stomach heals poison damage equal to wits and medicine, which requires plantain and ginger. You will gather more of these as time goes on.
Memorize these well, because they will serve you well in the fight against Gaia.
I thank you very much. This is very important knowledge you imparted to me. Is there anything I could do for you?
For me, there is nothing. But for your pack, keep them alive. They will need all of their strength.
With Gaia's grace.
Indeed. Just then you hear the call of the master of the trial, master of the challenge, bites the head of the worm, which is this pretty bastard right over here, dashes upon the rocks, wherever the hell I put him, which I don't think I did on this map. So, I will say that at this point, you follow along with the rest of the pack over to this map over here. Sean, if you could place your token somewhere here along the sidelines.
Yes.
You proceed to watch Cleft get his ass kicked as well.
In one hit. Yes.
Yes.
You, nice. You got your ass beat by a girl.
You got knocked the fuck out, man.
That's fine. That's fine. He knew he was going to lose, so he's not worried about it.
No, that's fucking virgin energy right there, if I ever heard it. Cleft Reed is a kissless virgin, that's what he is.
Woman's in the finals, so he lost.
Man retreats from a beautiful woman when she tries to kiss him.
She beat the living shit out of him, my man.
Yeah, exactly. you come out of here with this pussy shit.
I don't kiss beautiful woman.
What happened to the last born herb?
Yes.
Did he give me any herbs, or did he just show me the recipes for these herbs?
He showed you the recipes for them, and I'll say that he gave you a starting kit of each. I'll let you pick one of the three to start with.
Okay. Let me look at them again.
So you have mint bone, which heals. Fire damage, Luna Leaf, which heals silver, Mother Stomach, which heals poison damage.
Let's go, Luna Leaf.
Okay, I will say that you have one charge of Luna Leaf. Please add that to your notes.
Got it.
Okay, so you watched Clef get his ass beat. You watched a very intense fight between Autumn Leafs and Jennifer. And for the last... Here, give me one second. I gotta save something real quick because
pretty sure we can pick all these up at the local grocery store.
Nice.
You've been scammed.
Well, no, he didn't scam you. He gave you what you needed.
Yeah. The only thing that might be a little bit harder is Luna Leaf ingredients.
Yes.
That's it.
What year is it?
1998.
I bet there's like herbal shops around.
You're a 90s kid. You remember going to the herbal shop.
There's probably an apothecary somewhere back in town. There's a lot of farms out here. Okay, so for the final battle of the trial, let me find some song for it. Get this real quick.
The fuck is this? Let's see.
All right, so what?
We'll post that in Roll 20. Yeah, there you go.
Hell did you make?
I've been making a visual depiction of Ruatma from Rage Across Heaven.
I'm sad I missed that episode, bro.
That's the living incarnation of the planet Uranus.
He's scrolling in the Uranus, man.
You got a witch in Uranus, Kyle.
Okay.
As you all witnessed the first two fights... dashes upon the rock, steps between the competitors.
Remember, for this last and final fight, to decide the alpha of this pack, gifts will be allowed.
All right.
Ephemeris, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Wendigo, are you ready?
Do you even need to ask me that?
He does. It's kind of a tradition.
Yes, I am prepared.
All right.
Then may the fight begin. All right, both of you roll initiative.
Can we get the initiative tracker?
Yes, we may.
Why?
Let's see. There is a fucking 9.
Where the hell is my initiative again? On the combat page.
Son of a fucking bitch. Alright.
Jennifer, you
Well, we might as well just hand off victory to you.
There is no guarantee of that. Jennifer, you have the first move.
Yes.
Okay.
Same as Warhammer.
Yeah, I come flying across the clearing, land behind end of the road, and just rake two-handed claws across the back.
All right. Here. Please roll the hit.
By difficulty Jesus, 6. I will fucking kill you.
Actually, it was 6 or 7, because we had this issue last time.
Are you talking about the claw attack?
Yeah.
That's 7.
7.
Oh, it's 7, okay. Claw attack, difficulty yeah. 7, Jennifer.
Let's see. I'm at...
2 successes.
I'll make my dodge roll. I'm playing with the starfish at the moment. Okay.
Don't diddle with the starfish, man.
The starfish has to be done.
Why do you have a starfish?
We're making a starfish for Dungeons and Dragons on Wednesday.
Alright. How many fucking 6s I rolled? Oh well.
Let's see, son of a bitch. God's grace goes into effect. That one becomes a 2.
That is 2 successes. You just barely managed to dodge that.
Yeah, bring my spine in.
Jennifer, would you like to burn rage?
I would. At least I think I do. Mm. That's it under advantages?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, so it's point of rage spent. I'm going to bite.
Alright. Please roll your bite attack. Difficulty 6. Mm. Six successes.
Son of a fucking bitch.
Please roll dodge, difficulty 6.
Alright. Well, guess what? There's no way I'm going to be able to avoid even with God's grace going off. That's 3 successes.
Well, 4 successes because difficulty 6. Actually, no. Yeah, bite's difficulty 6, right?
It's 3, yeah.
Okay. Yeah. That's not going to. Okay, Jennifer, you sink your fangs into End's shoulder, which deals. That's your strength and Incrinus form. Let me check that real quick.
Straight strength.
3 strength plus your Crinus form bonus, which. Is
that's 4.
Four. That is 7. That is 7 damage. Ends the road. Please roll soak.
Alright.
Difficulty 6.
We soak 3 of those points.
Soak 3 points of damage. You have taken 4 aggravated damage. Jennifer, would you like to burn another rage?
Sure. I seem to have lots of it. And we'll throw another claw.
3 successes on the claw attack. Ends the road. Roll dodge.
God's grace. That's 3 successes.
3 successes. No. Hang on.
It's claw difficulty 7.
Difficulty 7. Shit. Okay, it's still difficulty 7. In that case,
2, 2.
Okay.
2 successes still.
Burning a point of willpower. I'm doing that on both of those ones.
Yep. Burn willpower.
Right.
With a 10 and a 4, that's 1, 2, 3. I think that's 4 successes then.
That's 4 successes in that case.
You managed to dodge that by the skin of your teeth. You are hurting, but you're still up. Jennifer, right. Would you like to keep going?
No, I'll let Ends of the Road have a turn.
All right. Ends of the Road, your turn.
All right. We're going to activate the Yu-Gi-Oh! Trap card. Okay. I still have a point of willpower to spend on this. Let's see. Control C. Control V. Devouring Grime.
Player, werewolf touches a target, spends 1 power. Target touched has their movement speed reduced to 0.
Yeah. I'll freeze you with this gift.
Okay.
So just movement.
Yeah.
Huh.
Just movement. So I'll freeze you to fuck solid. Right.
So you still have to roll so it's just spend 1 power and you just touch, or do you need to touch?
Yeah, that just you spend a point, what power it goes off.
Okay. Jennifer, you are frozen solid. Right. Well, just frozen in place. You are trapped to the ground by a little cone of ice around your legs. ends the road. Anything else we'd like to do on your turn?
Spam Power of Rage, going in for a bite attack. Let's see. Pop the dice. Ah, fuck's sake, wound penalty. That's two successes. My one becomes a two.
Two successes, and if she's frozen solid, she can still dodge, though.
That's your discretion, up to that.
Well, I think, it's just like feet, right? It's not like...
Yeah, she can still dodge. You can't really, like, move outside your 5-foot square there. How should I rule that? Because it says they're frozen there.
But difficulty 7?
Yeah, because, I will up the difficulty by 1 because you are frozen.
Okay, so difficulty...
Dodge, and that was a bite attack, so difficulty 7, I believe that is.
Yeah.
Yep,
5 successes.
5 successes, burning another Power of Rage, going for another attack. Let's see. I can burn 3 of these. Alright. Going in for... Let's see. Claw attack on you. Made that wrong, probably. Alright, there we go.
Well, actually, that's two tens. That's a crit. That's three successes.
All right, using willpower on the 2 4s.
All right. 3 successes. Or actually, no, 4 successes now because that's a crit.
4 successes on that.
Jennifer, dodge. 4 successes. That's a claw attack. Yup.
See, son of a fucking bitch, Meepium. You're killing
me here.
Good
lord,
All right. We have one more point of rage we can spend on this.
Okay. Ends the road one more.
I gotta end it with this one shot. Alright.
Claw attack, 3 successes.
Yeah. See.
I see.
In that case, I'm stepping backwards. You gotta burn rage in order to get me now.
Yes. Okay.
Wait a minute.
What's up?
She's leaving her range.
Dead right attack of opportunity in that.
Because you stepped away because she is frozen, I'll rule that no, because she can't. Well, she can, but I'm gonna up the difficulty by 1.
But it would be basically a free attack, right?
Well, yeah, you are stepping away. John, do you want to redact that?
See, no, Devouring Grom, I used it for a reason.
All right.
Okay.
Jennifer, would you like to try and reach at plus 1 difficulty?
Sure.
All right.
Swing a claw.
Claw attack difficulty 8 because of frozen. 2 successes. Any willpower spent on that 1.
All right.
Oh, sure. Let's do that.
Let's see. All right. There we go.
With 6, that is 1, 2, 3. Meets a beat, ends the road. Would you like to roll a willpower on one of those ones to try and... Because you were neck and neck at 3 and 3.
Well, I mean meets a beat.
Never mind.
Yeah. Right,
so, just barely manages to dodge. Jennifer, it is your turn.
All right.
Okay, I'll spend that rage that I need to move.
Okay, you crack away from the ice and you are home free to move.
And then I'm going to pounce on ends of the road.
Okay.
That is no longer that. That is no longer that.
Yep.
And bite.
Looking at that. Bite. Let's see.
There is a 1. Spend the willpower.
So oh, maybe. Yeah.
You conspiring against me on them leaves.
Yes.
Right. There it is.
To be fair, I think everyone is at this point.
Roll that willpower, or...
Let's see. I don't think she needs to by this point because I failed the dodge roll.
Oh, wait. Yeah, never mind. Okay. That attack lands just barely. Ends the road. Roll dodge.
See, I did.
Oh, sorry. Roll soak.
Yeah. See, there we go. Nope, I'm out.
Ooh, with that is all the rest of that, and ends the road is down for the count.
See.
Jennifer is victorious.
Right.
Okay, I guess it's time to howl. Oh!
Is anyone going to help her up? Because I don't want to be anywhere near her when she wakes up. She's going to be angry.
Siddhartha. Siddhartha.
There you go, Siddhartha.
Good luck.
Gilliger.
Your fear is right. Dark his shoulders. Take a step back.
What did you say? Sorry, I couldn't hear.
Heal her. Use a gift.
We're leaving Gilliger? You to deal with ends the road.
We're going to let you defuse the bomb.
Basically, that was. Let's see. Well, that was all claw attacks. Shouldn't have been aggravated damage.
Yeah.
Yep.
Bites and claws, man.
That is going to need a mother's touch. Sid, if you don't want to do it, we have your very talented friend over here as well.
I'll mother's touch.
All right. Mother's touch, I believe that is wits and medicine equal to the subject's permanent rage, if I'm remembering the rules correctly.
Yes.
Which, ends the road's permanent rage is, let me check that real quick.
Huge.
I mean,
number. One, that was a number, man.
Yeah. Oh, it says, I have it as intelligence medicine, is that correct?
Oh, yeah, you're right, intelligence medicine, my mistake.
Six.
Okay. Yep, difficulty six.
Mm-hmm.
I have the books up right now if anyone needs rulings.
Yeah, I actually need to do the same.
Ooh, four successes.
Four successes. Ends the road. You have healed 4 points.
Let's see. Four aggravated and all superficial. The superficial doesn't necessarily matter.
Yep.
Let's see. Three. Four. So it is both Russia and Appalachia where Meepin's the alpha dog.
This is the Meep alpha arc.
Yes.
Oh, I'm gonna say this. Here, there's a challenge, there's a good thing. In Russia, there's like, nobody wanted this and they gave it to Meepin.
Divine right. Now, do you think the Shadow Lord is gonna take answering to anybody who isn't also a Shadow Lord?
Yes.
That's true. I mean, if they take the beating, they have to.
Yes. Gonna just laying still, just absolutely boiling over. Kyle, point of rage, may I get temporary?
Yes, you may. You've been defeated by a get ephemeris. How the hell did that happen?
You fucking bitch!
Hey, you're talking to Alpha.
Do you want another one?
Just looking at that. I'm gonna get up right now. I'm not finished with you!
Enough! This fight is done.
Fight's over. Jennifer, there's no way you're okay with this.
It doesn't matter what I think. What matters is what is done. Jennifer, before Dashes Upon the Rocks can speak, an acorn hits him in the head. Jennifer! All right. Who is that? Ends the road, a rabbit hops up next to you.
Good.
Oh, boy.
Turn my head and go and look around. Just absolutely feel... I'm clenching my jaw so much it's starting to hurt my teeth.
Yuktena is going to come on over, and he's going to try and heal you the rest of the way. Actually, let me check your sheet real quick. Ends the road. You are at... Okay, you need like three more, I think. Mm-hmm. He could probably do that. He's going to burn Gnosis, and I think that was 5d10 for him.
Mm-hmm.
Roll 5d10.
My blood pressure's through the roof.
He's going to roll willpower on that.
Let's see.
You are healed up the rest of the way, ends the road.
Let's see. Healed up the rest of the way. Absolutely livid over this whole situation.
The rabbit starts hopping over to a small pond that sits here in the corner and then sits by it.
I will try to go sideways if I can. Go to the pond and look at it.
Alright, roll Gnosis difficulty 5.
You know what? I'll go with him.
Is this the rabbit here?
Yes. Yeah. Sorry, it's kind of hard to it's kind of hard to see under all this foliage. Excellent camouflage.
Okay. By the way, I shifted back to Homer form ages ago. Oh, I know, maybe not. Lupus.
Yep.
I'm still incredible, by the way.
Autumn Leafs, you step sideways. You are in the Umbra, and who is there to greet you? None other than where the hell did I put him? What's the problem with having all these goddamn characters? Like, I can't fucking keep track of all this shit.
What was the difficulty for stepping sideways again?
I'm sorry. You were five. Just outside of a cairn.
I forgot to spend XP.
It's all good. I'm
Left, saving mine.
Sideways.
See, stepping sideways indeed. Dear. What happens next?
Bravo! Bravo! Hang on, where's the rest of yous? I expected the rest of yous if I'm to make somebody an alpha of this pack, aren't I?
I mean...
You want me to go get them?
Oh, no, I'll get them.
Ends the road, roll a d10.
See, d10? Yeah. Alright. See, let's go ahead. Close that. Too many tabs up in another page.
That's why I have three monitors.
I kind of want a third one, but I don't need desk space. Ends the road, you slip sideways.
Alright. Let's see. Alright, slip sideways indeed. And fly goes off.
You get up, you trip, you tumble, and there is Hare standing right before the pond.
Now, where was the pretty looking woman with the long blonde hair?
And it means he's here to buy more material.
Okay, yeah, I'm gonna need somebody to go back and get the rest of yous.
I'll be right back.
All right.
Absolute fucking fury.
Genosis, you are
sorry,
right
I was in the middle of rolling.
Umbra. No problem.
In that moment, I'm sensing a little bit of fury. If ends the road, I'm gonna just put my forehead on her arm.
Just no, you are gonna feel my entire body is just twitching right now. It's like a pit bull about to jump on to jump on a squirrel, just like that.
And I'm being right now, anti-panic attack dog.
Basically, the red talon being a good therapy dog. Imagine that.
I'm not looking at you while I'm doing this. Just staring forward, just stewing right now. I know whatever Hare's going to say, I don't want to hear it.
Okay, so somebody comes back and tells me to go sideways?
Yes, Cleft is immediately back through the Umbra.
Hey, Hare's over there. He wants all of us to come over. And he's going to look to Eugen and Siddhartha.
Another rabbit's going to hop over and sort of like jump near Sid and gesture for him to... Actually, I probably should have... Now I'm thinking about it. I probably should have had Sid talk to Octana after... Or Sid talk to Licks the Wounds after this, but I didn't think that through.
Lick my wounds?
Yeah. Anyway... yeah. I do apologize that this isn't the most active session for you right now because you didn't want to be the pack alpha.
It's going long for a ride.
Yeah, no, it's cool. Aurelonosis.
Okay, Siddhartha is through the Umbra. And Jen, did you roll? Oh, wait, you did roll. Okay.
Yes.
All right, so you come a little bit later.
There you all are. Good fight, good fight. I saw the whole thing. Excellent work from all of yous that fought. You, sir, you put up a valiant effort, but, you know, well, all of you put up a valiant effort, especially you. Excellent work. And he's going to tap you on the, he's going to tap you on the shoulder with a carrot-shaped scepter.
But remember, to be the leader of a pack, you don't just have to be the strongest one out of all of us. You gotta be the smartest, the brains of the operation. Without a pack alpha telling you which ways to go, you can't be going very far. Oh, come on. I expected a little more lively attitude than that.
I was just kind of waiting for my turn to talk. I'm proud to serve as alpha for your pack.
Now hold your horses. Like I said, you did a great job with the fighting. But in order to be a proper pack alpha, you gotta have the smarts too to lead this pack. Which is why I, in my infinite wisdom, had come up with a part two for the challenge.
Oh god.
Excuse me, fellas. And four rabbits hop around. And I will mark each of them with a different color. Give me one moment, please. One there.
It's going to be the there. Green one.
One there. The
because that is your token outline, of course.
One there.
No, it's because it's always green for some reason.
So, these are my friends over here. Get very well acquainted with each one of them. They's gonna be your buddy for this next one. Well, your buddy and your foe. Like I said, it's good to have the smarts, because that's what this is all about. Leading an operation takes a good bit of thinking under your noggin. My next challenge for you is a little old-fashioned game of hide-and-seek. So, once you get acquainted with your rabbit, let him loose in the woods, count yourselves to 20, and then go out and hunt. You find your rabbit, you bring the rabbit back to me, and whoever brings the rabbit back to me first gets another point.
So, are these normal rabbits, or are these rabbit spirits?
Doc, where do you think you are? Use your noggin if you want to beat a pack alpha. You got another shot at this, despite your valiant effort.
I never thought I was going to be the pack alpha. I wanted to try.
And you could try and try again, and that's what this is about. I'm a big fan of second chances. And you, Miss Huffy, he's going to like slide his head between your legs and stare up at you. You can see that scold all you want, but unless you keep on trying, you might never get the opportunity to do this again.
Yes, sir.
No, don't sir me. Remember, I'm here. Your friend, your buddy, your pal.
I understand.
Alrighty, so, take some time, get well acquainted with your rabbit. Everybody acquainted with the rabbit?
I would actually like to talk to my rabbit.
Same.
Well, talk to the rabbit.
I'm guessing this is out of character. I'm guessing he's still an animal, whether it's spirit or not. Does my beast affinity help with this?
Does your what?
Beast affinity, my merit.
Your merit all, for beast all affinity. Rolls.
I'll copy this.
Yes, it does. The rabbit seems very well enthused with you. Meanwhile, Autumn Leaf, you're having a hard time keeping this rabbit within distance, do you?
I'm trying, because I didn't release him per se. I will try to take him in my hands like rabbit, but not squish it, because I'm still in cringe form.
He keeps trying to jump away from you. He doesn't like the look of you.
Fair.
Well, no, it's one of his flaws.
I have flaw, yeah.
Jenner ends, do you have any merits or flaws that would help you in this endeavor?
Let's see. Merits, flaws, not on me. I do have a point in ammo, Ken.
Okay, well, if you would like, those of you who don't have a merit that is actually better yet, go ahead to get acquainted with your wabbit. Go ahead and do me a flavor. And, oh wait, no, that's the wrong one. Put that over there.
I'm also going to try and get this guy's scent.
Yep. Roll me wits and primal urge for, it's going to be difficulty 6. Clef, do it at difficulty 5. Getting the scent is going to be wits and primal urge at difficulty 6. Getting the rabbit to actually get to know you, that is going to be a charisma and primal urge.
So this one was my wits, the first one.
Wits this and Primal Urge. Clef, because of your affinity, you get an automatic success with the getting the rabbit to know you with Charisma and Primal Urge. And
this is difficulty 6?
Yes, so, yes. Annalise?
I'm so glad.
Annalise, you should be healed back up all the way, so roll one extra... are you still at minus one wound penalty?
Yeah, I was, I was, you know, full HP was stacked and I was healed by, like, 4 points.
Oh, shit, okay.
I mean, I didn't mind it.
Well, yeah, but do me a favor just to even it up. I'll let you get that point back.
Ma, I'm also going to use a willpower on this one.
Okay.
I'm going to roll one of these.
Big ball. Love Jennifer Holiday collecting stuff.
Nice. Success.
Okay,
Leafs. 4 successes.
Yeah, so, 4 successes,
sorry.
Yeah, 2 successes from Clef, 4, and that was for... Was that
3 plus the 1 automatic.
Yeah, but that was getting the scent or getting the rabbit to know you?
That's the charisma. The first one, I rolled a 1 for getting the scent.
So the rabbit takes a cautious sniff at you, Clef, and then just sort of sits at your feet. It seems to like you. Jennifer Holiday, wolf stuff, that was your wits and primal urge, I imagine?
Yep.
You have a very distinct scent of this rabbit in particular. Autumn Leafs, you rolled... I assume...
First scent.
Even though he keeps evading you, he leaves a very, very distinct scent trail. With your 4 successes, you will have no trouble being able to track this.
And then we can also befriend it with charisma plus primal urge?
Yes, you may. That will be a difficulty 6.
Okay, I will tell him that I've got a deal for him. If he hides somewhere easy, I will bring him back in my hands instead of my teeth.
Okay, charisma and primal urge.
Oh, shit.
Nope, just very scary.
The rabbit does not believe you.
Just get a point of rage for that?
Yeah, you can get a point of rage, and would you like to roll willpower to try and reroll that 1?
Yes.
Alright, go right ahead and roll willpower. Alright, that undoes that 1, but that's still not quite enough. Yep, the rabbit... Instead of running away from you, then just sort of hangs around and, you know, scratches his ear and just bounces around a little bit more. Okay, ends the road. Was there any scent catching or sweet talking you would like to do to your rabbit?
I'm looking at the rabbit like this.
The rabbit starts hopping away.
Yes.
I'm probably the only one petting the rabbit.
Yep. Clef, the rabbit has settled into your legs and is just sitting there very comfortably enjoying the ear scritchies.
I mean, you don't have to leave. You can just stay here.
All right, everybody well acquainted.
Do I catch the scent with the 1 success I rolled earlier?
It's hard to distinguish from the other rabbits, but... Gotcha. Yes, you do.
All right.
I'm ready.
All right. Well, may the game begin. As suddenly your rabbits just vanish out of thin air, as if they were never there in the first place.
Okay.
I'm going to forge with his bow. And we'll hunt down that rabbit.
Right.
All right.
You'll make the roll. Okay.
So,
Storyteller, I have a gift just for this. All right. Go ahead. Copy that text for you. Spend a point of gnosis, speed up the heart drum.
Wait. Did you taste the blood of the bunny?
Sadly, you did not get to take a bite of the bunny or a bite of the hare, so sadly, that will not work in your favor, I'm sorry to say.
See. All right.
So, you're going to have to do it by smell alone.
See, all right, then. What roll do you want me to make?
All right, so to track your prey, if you would like to track your prey by scent, this will be a roll of, I'm going to say that's perception and primal urge at difficulty 8. These are very hard rabbits to find. For those of you that took the time to catch the scent, reduce that difficulty by 1.
Okay.
Perception, primal urge, all right. There we go.
Autumn leaves, you are suddenly caught in the blend of the forest as, you know, the burst of the energy from the rabbits just dissipating into thin air catches you off guard.
Wait a minute.
What?
I'm spending 1 willpower.
Yes.
Temporary, and I will gonna use the gift, which is funny. Where are the gifts?
Walk at the door.
Yeah, of course, this one.
Let's see what you get.
Strength of purpose. Once per turn, stamina plus rituals, difficulty 7, 1 success equals 2 temporary willpower. Page 130.
Patty? Let me go pull the
book. Yeah, in the book if you want, like, specific.
Yeah, give me one sec. Let me find where I put the notes. Is this Player's Guide or Core Rulebook?
Core.
Gotcha. And that's page 130, right?
Yep. 130.
All right. Got it. 130.
What was
Strength of Purpose. Hang on. Where are you looking at?
Show a description of what you're looking at.
It might be a little bit up.
Just copy and paste it if you can.
Strength of purpose, I never made that gift of 3.5.
Yeah, that's why I'm looking at
it. Here, I found it right here. Let me...
Oh, yeah.
It's right over here. There we are. That's strength of purpose.
Right.
Okay, so... Once per sense, the player rolls stamina rituals, difficulty 7... Gain 2 temporary willpower points. You may go ahead and roll stamina and rituals at difficulty 7.
Okay. I can have only temporary willpower equal to my permanent, right?
Yes. Yeah, I'm going to say that just for balance.
So, with extra 2, I'm going to automatically spend it so I can reroll the 3 dice in the hunt.
Well, hold on to that. I'm going to let everybody else take a turn real quick first.
Okay. You said it was difficulty 8?
Yeah, were you going to scent out the rabbit?
Yeah, and then it was reduced by 1.
Reduced by 1 if you took the scent of the rabbit.
Right.
Which I believe you did, so.
Before I click the wrong fucking button.
Yes.
Oh, fuck.
You think you got it, and then you don't quite got it. Hera will speak up. Remember, these are friends of mine. You gotta treat them gently. That means don't eat them. And besides, spirits don't taste as good as regular rabbit does. Only if you make it properly, that is.
It's fine. I'm just gonna go around yelling out, I've got the scratches.
The scratches?
Okay.
What?
Well, I'll let Jennifer roll first because she hasn't done anything yet. Would you like to catch the scent or try
perception
to coax
plus up? Primal urge, or what's the roll here?
Did you take you caught the scent of the rabbit, didn't you? No, you tried to.
Yes.
Okay, you caught the scent of the rabbit, so that will be perception and primal urge at difficulty 7.
Oops, perception. I was rolling wits.
Oh, Cleft, if that's the case, do you want to roll that again with
perception? I have significantly more.
Yes.
It says you roll perception on wits.
I'm not sure.
I'm going to burn a willpower for that one.
All right, go ahead and burn the willpower. All right.
9.
Both Jen and Cleft have 2 successes. Cleft, it's somewhere over here. Jen, yours is somewhere over here. So those two are getting closer. ends the road. How will you be pursuing your wabbit?
I made this roll a while ago. 10, 9, 4, 6, 2, and 9.
And that was your scent gland?
Perception, primal urge.
Perception and primal urge. Your rabbit is somewhere over here.
Let's see. Alright. Go look over. What are you doing, Sidharth? I'm going to look at you.
Hare is going to walk over to Sidharth. So you're not from around here, are you? Where is you from? I kind of like you.
I'm from India.
Oh, India. I wasn't close to India one time, but I do remember I was in this cave with a couple of folks with long robes and twirly beards and this large guy with a machete who always yelled about, "Hasha! Chop!" I pretended to be a genie to get out of that one.
Sounds like quite the unfortunate circumstance. Sorry you didn't have a more favorable impression of my country.
Well, like I said, Doc, I ain't never been to India. I'd love to travel it one day. You know, I love traveling.
Siddhartha, I'm just going to storm over to you.
Okay.
And immediately I'm wrapping my arms around you.
Okay, I'm a little confused.
See, what form are you in for this?
Probably right now, I'd say lupus, maybe.
See, I'm going to scoop you up. I'm just going to, like, do the thing that cats do, where I just, like, press my cheek against you and just rub it, like, all across you.
Okay.
Somebody and doesn't then, like to focus on a task at hand. Wonder if I could fix that.
After that, I'm going to look at Siddhartha. I'm going to put you down. I'm going to say, go that way for me.
Okay. Excuse me. I think he has some business. And I'll walk the other way.
Yeah.
Very confused, by the way.
See, using you as a plan. I'm getting my scent on you to throw off that rabbit.
I see.
Yeah. See, and with that, I'm going to go make a wide berth all the way around this way.
Yes. So you know that yours is somewhere around in this area here.
Mm-hmm. See. Okay. I'm going to stand over here, arms crossed, waiting for Sid to get into position.
Okay. So, if that is the case, Autumn Leaves, would you like to try and roll Perception and Primal Urge?
I'm going to re-roll these 3 dice.
Yes. Oh, yeah, you didn't get to re-roll, did you?
Yeah, because you said, like, okay, give me a moment, and I gave you a moment.
Sorry. Yeah. Go ahead and re-roll that.
Oh, yeah. 2 successes, I think it will be.
Yep, so that's a 3, a 10, and a 2 with your old roll. That would be, and you caught the scent, so that's difficulty 7. So that would be 3 successes. You know that your rabbit is hiding somewhere over here.
Okay. So I will try to sneak on up on him. Technically, I'm not in Krynos, but I'm going to use the token anyway. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I'm just trying to close the distance sneakily.
All right. So, if you are trying to go stealth, roll dexterity and stealth at difficulty 8.
Okay.
See this roll. It's going to be fantastic.
Dear. Difficulty 8. I mean, werewolves are kind of ambush predators as well.
That's true.
Let's see. There we go.
Yeah, 4 successes. I'm invisible.
4 successes. You are invisible. I will let you go ahead and... Are you in lupus form or chronis form?
Hispo form.
Hispo form, okay. I will let you get your full movement to whichever way in this general direction that you would like to go.
Yeah,
I just close step by step, near the ground, and we'll try just close the distance to see if I can spot the rabbit. And I'm gonna... I'm gonna stop here and see if I can see him with my eyes.
Okay, just to see with your eyes, that's going to be, I think that's perception and awareness at difficulty 7.
Oh. I don't think awareness? There is awareness?
Oh, no, not awareness. It's, what is it called?
Alertness?
Alertness, that's it.
Okay. Difficulty 7.
Yes.
Let's see.
I have a success.
One success. You think it might be somewhere over here. Somewhere hiding amongst these mounds of dirt. You thought you saw it, but you're not entirely sure. Jennifer, are you going to try and mark the scent again? Or wait, no, I told you yours was... You got your scent, I think. Let me check. Oh, wait, no.
Yeah.
Wolf stuff, and you rolled that, so you had 2 successes. You know your wolf, or you know your rabbit is somewhere over here.
Okay. So, I move to here.
All right. Are you going to stealth in, or are you going to walk in?
Let's make it stealthy, because I think that's a good plan.
All right, Dex and Stealth, difficulty 8.
Take a look at this roll. See.
All right. You managed to get pretty close. You smell the scent. It's very strong. It's right under your nose. Would you like to try and spot it?
Yes.
All right, roll me a perception and alertness at difficulty 7.
Keep going for this roll.
Okay. I'm just changing my wolf stuff around to be with what I need.
Yep.
Bark!
The foliage is too dense. You smell it. You are right on top of it, but you can't quite smell it. Would you like to roll willpower?
No.
All right, gain a point of rage for that -1 then. Cleft, you are still here. You can't quite catch the scent, but you did get pretty well acquainted with your rabbit. Would you like to try and coax it out?
Of course. Right. Where was it?
Please roll me a... I think... And what form are you in?
I'm currently in lupus.
You're in lupus form, so let me go ahead and check something real quick.
All right, we're still in the carriage, so we have to be in lupus, right?
Yes, that is correct. Okay, that is going to be charisma and primal urge at difficulty. I think you got acquainted with it, so that's going to be difficulty 7 for you.
Mm-hmm.
Charisma and primal urge?
Yes.
Difficulty 7?
Yes.
Yeah, all right.
Hey. 2 successes. What would you like to say to the rabbit?
Hey, it's just come out. Pet you again.
You hear a slight rustling. It's close. It's real close to you. Keep this up and you just might have it. Okay, Ends the road. What would you like to do?
Let's see. I'm going to look at Sid. I'm going to give him the beckoning finger.
I will approach.
Okay. Are you running up to her or are you going stealthy?
Let's see.
I'll go quietly. I'll try to go quietly.
All right, Dex.
I understand what's going on here.
Dex and stealth difficulty 8.
Let's go and look at you with my arms crossed. Just trying to get the pit bull twitches under control.
Oh wait, sorry, wrong difficulty.
Yep.
All right. Partially placed my benefit. See. Nope. That's... It doesn't matter what you roll.
I don't know with that. Actually, hang on, was that? You rolled the 8 twice.
No, take the first one.
Would you like to roll the power?
I clicked it twice.
Yeah. It's just going in loud as hell.
How much do I have? I'll take a willpower.
Alright, give that willpower a roll.
Look at this. Kyle, I'm realizing what you're playing. See. We might need to credit this guy in the comments because that's a topic.
Is it actually?
Nope.
Oh, yes. I didn't know that.
Yeah.
You do get rid of the one, Siddhartha, so that is still one success. It's a little noisy, but I will let you go ahead and take your movement up to this clearing here.
Okay. Which clearing? Sorry, I didn't see.
Right over here.
Yeah.
Got it.
Yeah. Alright. Kyle, make sure we don't get a copyright strike. That video that you just posted into the Guzik channel, copy that description. We're going to have to paste that in the video when we post this.
Okay, that I can do.
Alright.
So, that being the case, Siddhartha, since you are there, actually, your scent glands should be enough to confuse the rabbit, I think.
Mm-hmm.
So, I'm going to say that the rabbit slowly hops out from the brush there.
Mm-hmm. All right. I am going to reach down. I'm going to grip that thing with my claw.
Okay. Make a grapple attack at difficulty 8.
Let's see. Strength and brawl, in that case?
I believe it is, yes. Alright, that is God's Grace. Alright,
God's Grace, one of those ones becomes a 2.
Alright, difficulty 8, that's 1. 2 successes. The rabbit is going to roll dodge, and I will be using hair's stats for this. Does hair actually stats? Have stats, now that I'm thinking about it?
Let's see. What do you use hair stat?
I don't think he does, actually. Let me check.
See. I don't believe I gave a rabbit stats.
No, you did not. But
you made a rabbit stat sheet for this game?
I was dumb and I did not, because I didn't think that far ahead.
Well, how many dice do you think this rabbit's going to dodge with?
Rabbits are pretty dexterous. I'm going to say that's 5d10.
All right, let's see it.
Dodge. I'll say 5d10.
This is a rabbit some more ship down, aren't they?
So hang on, you get 3 successes, right?
Yeah.
Yes. Actually, yeah. Wait, did I say difficulty 8 or 7?
You said 8.
Yeah, so that's 2 success. Wait, so one of those ones becomes a 2, and you had an 8 there. So wait.
That's 8 success.
Yeah, so 1 success.
Mm-hmm.
All right. At that brawl attack, the rabbit immediately darts away.
Let's see. Burning a point of rage to chase after it.
All right, go ahead and chase after it.
Just gonna speed right after this. Leaves. You keep saying how slow I am.
Yep.
See, darting after that thing at full blast, full sprint.
All right, would you like to burn rage to make another grapple attack then?
Roll the 12d10.
Yes.
All right, let's go. Click it.
Ooh! Oh my there goodness we go. Gracious. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 successes. The rabbit's gonna have to do some nut shit to do this.
List of rabbit crits.
And no, it is not. You snatch up the rabbit.
I reach it up.
Before you...
Before I can what?
Alright, so, you have your rabbit in hand.
Mm-hmm. What happens?
Hare is going to look at you and point at his feet.
Let's see. That...
Before you make the dash, though, I'm going to give everyone else one last shot. Autumn Leafs, would you like to try and... would you like to try and spot the rabbit once more?
Yeah, I'm going to come even closer to...
Yep. You're still in stealth, perception, and awareness at difficulty 7.
Ooh, that's bad. Yeah.
No, it's
still
not good.
I don't saw it fully, but I'm going to go anywhere anyway.
Okay, you're going to walk up, and you almost step right on top of it as it gets stared. It gets scared and begins to dart away. It was right under your feet, and the rabbit starts booking it this way.
Fuck, I won't strike it.
Okay.
Question. I have... Nah, I was asking if I can catch up to him, or, you know...
You may burn a rage to catch up to it.
If he's near me, like, you know... Now what?
What's up?
40 foot.
Oh, sorry, no. You're still using your Krynos token. I just put your Lupus token off to the side.
Yeah.
Sorry, I forgot about that.
You know what? I'm gonna spend rage.
Okay.
To catch up to him.
I'm
gonna catch up to him and try. Because I'm with his bow, I'm gonna try. Not gonna crush it with my mouth, but I'm gonna try to catch it.
Okay, roll a grapple attack, dex and brawl, difficulty 8.
Autumn Leaves. Looking at you do this.
Dex and brawl. Difficulty 8.
Come on.
There is a success.
There is a success. Would you like to burn any willpower?
I don't have any.
All right, that rabbit is going to roll dodge.
Oh, fuck.
And that rabbit does indeed evade your grasp. So, Cleft, or actually no, Jen, would you like to try and spot your rabbit once again?
I'm going to use persuasion and
All right.
And actually, that is also a gift I would like to use. Only I don't have the.
What's up?
The what do you call it? The
text for it.
The text for it.
What is it? I can.
It's a Hamid gift.
Yeah, it is a Hamid gift. May substitute appearance for charisma or manipulation.
Dumb.
To an extent, I think that it worked because if you make yourself look non-threatening enough, then it might actually work. If you'd like to coax the rabbit towards you. Please roll your charisma and primal urge. I believe you failed getting acquainted at your rabbit, so I'll say difficulty 8.
Okay, but the persuasion gift I think does something different than that, because
that was supermodel. Was you substitute appearance for charisma or manipulation? Oh wait, you had an actual gift for it.
Yes.
Oh, persuasion. It's called... Let me check that real quick. Persuasion.
Persuasion. See, pulling this up as well.
Persuasion. Let me post that in the chat.
Manipulation subterfuge difficulty 6. For every success, all difficulties involving social situations are reduced by 1.
All right.
Okay.
So I'll let you roll manipulation and subterfuge difficulty 6.
5. And subterfuge, so that's 7 dice.
See what you get with this.
Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Good lord. So, if you'd like to coax the rabbit out, that will be...
Difficulty 3?
Yes, that is Persuasion and Primal Urge Difficulty 3. Alright,
so that's...
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 successes.
Nothing but successes.
Yes, all successes. So, the rabbit, seeing this very, very pretty and cuddly-looking wolf, is going to poke its head up from the brush, and it is going to slowly hop back over to you.
Okay, I will scoop it up and take a step.
It's fucking the sheer amount of hatred towards this character.
Oh, that is a mixed drink. Oh, thank you very much, sir. You're very kind. Sorry, my roommate just handed me a mixed drink.
How many red pills are in it?
None. It is whiskey, I think. Give me a sec.
It's in it.
It's scotch.
That is a very good old fashioned. That's a very good old fashioned.
Whiskey and cough syrup.
We had a bunch of blue wines the other day. I've got 2 bartending books that I got from my grandfather. Mm-hmm. So we've just been digging into them.
Let's see.
Okay. So Jennifer has taken the step with the rabbit in tow.
Yep.
Well, you catch more flies with sugar than you do with vinegar. What can I say? Use a natural.
Both of you had the rabbit in your grasp, and yet this Hamid just scooped it up in her arms and walked over.
I was about to fucking offer it a vegetable stew.
And honestly, that probably, if you rolled that right, you probably would have gotten it. The rabbit hops over to you.
Well, I think that just about decides it. We got the strongest and the smartest. And, Miss Wendigo, that was an excellent trick using your pack mate, good leadership skills. But, 2 points is 2 points. And she did win using her wits and her good looks. So, could all the pack please get around me?
I like to think the bunny's riding on my feathers.
What's up?
I like to think the bunny is riding on my shoulders.
Yes, Cleft the Rabbit seems to really like you.
Come on now, all of you, don't be shy.
Just looking at this, just this rabbit in my hand. I'm lucid enough to know that I'm about to turn its spine, windpipe, and carotid artery into one tube, so I'm gonna drop it before I do that.
Both rabbits come speeding back over to Hare.
As I'm walking over, Autumn, you can just hear my teeth like clicking as they're about to break in my mouth.
Now then, with water pick in attendance,
he's going to take out his carrot-shaped scepter.
Jennifer Holiday of Tribe Getafemis. Would you please kneel before the Great Hare?
I will do so.
By the power vested in me from the Great Mother, I hereby name you Pack Alpha. Now then, every Papa Pack needs a proper name. So what will your pack be?
In honor of the Great Hair that we follow, we will be the Playboys.
I'm gonna say this. I'm a boy and I like to play. But how does this even is near hair?
It is the traditional costume of the Playboy Bunny.
She's right, you know. Good-looking girls.
Costume?
Don't worry about it, Doc. It's a helmet thing. Don't worry about it.
Helmet thing? I mean, I cannot disagree now.
Well, and so it is. The Get Ephemeris leads the Playboys. Congratulations, Doc. Seeing the ends of the road is rather glum. Hair is going to pop up and just kind of sit on her shoulder. You know, that was some excellent work, and you could honestly do a great job in this pack with that sort of strategic mindset. Your leader could use a head like that. If a good looks can't carry you, then I'm sure the rest of you will step up to help. Especially you. He's going to poke you in the stomach, ends the road, with his scepter.
The veins throbbing my neck, the throbbing in my forehead. I'm not looking at him. I'm not saying anything. And to my perspective, this is what insanity is. That out of all things, when it goes brood totem, is supporting the Get Ephemeris, and I feel like I'm about to go insane from this happening.
Alrighty then. Now, if my choices are correct, you folks got some nasty work ahead of you. I hear that there's some creepy wolf roaming around here, eating other wolves.
Oh, that thing. Yeah, we'll need to take care of it.
You absolutely will. So, in order to get you nice and spiced up for the journey, here's to the mother. He's going to stamp the carrot into his, into the ground. And I would like all of you to gain, first of all, the pack benefits,
the hair benefits
of having Hare's totem. Now let me go ahead and find where the fuck Hare is on this actual thing.
See,
page 199
of the player's guide.
Yeah.
Oh, player's guide, right. Hang on. I gotta have all my fucking shit up before I get started with this. All right.
One level in athletics, one in dodge.
All right. That's here. One level in athletics, one level in dodge. Werewolf games, 10 extra move. Actually, yeah, that's a lot. Level athletics, dodge, primal urge, stealth. And when retreating from an enemy, you get 10 feet of extra movement in all forms. No shame in running when you can't win some fights. So far, that hasn't been an issue, but you never
did know. I already do this?
So did I.
Yeah, okay. I thought it was because when we first got him as a totem. That's why I added everything already.
Yeah, okay. I got these stats already.
So add those, and I will also say please refresh your gnosis and willpower back to their original peaks.
Oh, thank God. My gnosis was already full. It's just my willpower.
Yes.
My willpower was almost out.
There you go. Alrighty. So, know that me and all my friends will be watching your journey and being here to help you wherever we can. This fight's for all of us. So, I will bid you. He's going to step on the ground and a little hole will appear, like a little rabbit hole in the ground right here. I bid you adieu.
Bye, Hare.
Bye.
Save
Do
trouble.
These bunnies disappear? Because I owe this one a vegetable stew.
They'll be around, don't you worry, Doc.
Alright. I mean, the others are welcome to join.
Well, I'll take you up on it too one day. Toodaloo, Moyle.
And all of you, as you step through the rabbit hole, fall back out on the other side, back into the real world, or back into the physical plane. As
refresh my memory, what was dodge?
Dodge was leadership.
Oh, that's right. Okay.
These two come running back over as Hare and all of his other rabbits vanish.
Well, what did the Great Hare decide?
Jennifer will hold up a hand.
Get ephemeris. You'll be a strong pack. Now then, we must return. We have to hunt that spiral.
Yes, for you.
It.
I saw Enderus just running and I'm going after her.
Just spin around, just dipped out of the scene, just storming off into the forest.
Okay. If that is the case, ends and Autumn leaves, I will go ahead and give you your own scene then.
Just come in through stage left?
Yep.
See, just absolutely stewing.
Where are you going?
See.
Stay here!
I'm looking around. Where is the... You say we're in a mountain, right?
Yes.
Where's the stone wall?
Stone wall?
Yeah.
I'm gonna say that there is some, like, right over past these trees over here.
Yeah. See, immediately turning, heading for that. Just the way I'm walking, just every muscle in my body is tense. Just gonna go over to this. Alright, so the wall is just right here?
Mm-hmm.
Alright. Cross form?
Yeah.
So just gonna plant my knuckle against it, just to feel how stone straight a stone is.
It's a mountain that has stood for millennia.
Right. Pulling my fist back into it, seeing how much I can shatter in one punch.
Alright, roll dex and brawl. Right. Actually, just, it's a rock strength and brawl. Difficulty right. 8.
See, 12d10.
The rock crumbles like sand beneath your fist. Actually, no, that's difficulty 8. Yeah, 2 successes. You make a decent-sized crack in it.
Pulling back for another strike.
The crack widens slightly as some pebbles fall out. Your hand is starting to hurt.
See, just so I keep going at this.
Your hand is still starting to hurt. Roll soak, difficulty 8.
See, 4d10. No, hold on, man. The cross form. See, that's 7d10.
Yes.
So, still going at this.
Okay, I'm gonna charge.
And falling out now as
I'm gonna charge with her and just with my head just bump her so she gets off balanced.
Yes. See.
All right.
Off balance.
Roll
off
bashing balance. Attack. Dex and brawl.
Difficulty.
I think that difficulty is difficulty 6 or actually no, difficulty 7. I think.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
You whiff right past her as she is too engrossed in punching the wall.
Yes. See, there's 2 different rolls, the 4 and then the 0.
The first one, because I think I double clicked it.
Yes.
Alright, oh yeah, the first. Okay, so, are you not paying attention, ends the road, or are you going to try
not
to
looking at him.
What?
I'm not looking at him while I'm doing this.
Okay. Autumn Leafs, you manage to collide into Autumn Leafs and you stumble a little bit. Or ends the road. Yeah, Autumn Leafs. Ends the road, you stumble a little bit.
See, stumble. Catch myself on the rock wall. Okay, instead of taking my forehead, doing the exact same thing I was doing.
roll dex and brawl. No, strength and brawl again. Sorry.
Okay. Smashing my forehead into the wall.
Question.
Your forehead splits open, yes.
Yes.
Question. Does Krynos have a tail?
Yes, Krynos forms
have a tail. It does.
I'm gonna grab it with my jaw and pull it.
Okay, roll dex and brawl at difficulty 6. Three successes. Autumn Leafs, you're still engrossed in the wall. You feel teeth tug at your tail. That's a sharp pain all up your back.
So just talons, claws in the wall. I'm just going to look over my shoulder at you with like blood trickling down my forehead, looking right at you. I'm not saying anything.
There's a spiral nearby. You're going to get back to the pack.
There is no way you are okay with this.
I have to be.
And yet, Fenris Hamid is the alpha, and you're just taking it.
It's Get of Fenris as well.
Yeah.
It was the challenge.
Since when have the Red Talons respected the authority of the Get of Fenris?
I mean, there is a law. Without it, we are black spirals, just colliding into the worm. We need to obey it.
There is a law, and you are letting the white supremacist werewolf take over. You're letting a fucking honky lead us.
You also lose the battle. Don't tell me I'm doing this as well. You lost as I.
How are you okay with any of this?
I'm not okay, but it must be.
It must be. You are a Philodox. You have so. How many? How pure are your genes? You just let this happen.
You as well. Both are weaknesses, and now the price of it.
Looking at this. Well, point a finger at you. You fucking traitor. You conspired against me.
How could I expire against you if I fight her first?
Ends the road. I would like you to roll. Give me one moment. Check that real quick. Ends the road. I would like you to roll. How should I do that? Where is that on here?
See.
Roll me wits and subterfuge at difficulty 6. Ends the road. Autumn Leaves. Conversely, roll manipulation and subterfuge at same. That's a contested roll, I think.
Yep.
I did wits and subterfuge at difficulty 6.
Two successes, actually, God's grace.
Yep, two successes, God's grace. Manipulation and subterfuge at same difficulty, difficulty 6.
Six. Difficulty, right? Or 7?
Yes, difficulty 6.
Okay.
Oh, really? Oh, wait, that's because you're in lupus form, aren't you?
Yes.
No, in principle, but manipulation. Oh,
yeah,
right.
Manipulation tanks.
Oh, yeah, fuck, I forgot about that. As a lupus, he's rather unconvincing as the road. You are convinced that there is something at play. He had to have. There's no other way this could have happened.
Yeah. Look at this. What kind of brother are you?
The one who must do what must do.
You. Your laws! You stab someone in the back. You've known me for how many years, and you automatically assign with that fucking cunt.
I see. I saw this happen before. It couldn't happen again.
You've seen this happen before. You've seen it before. Where?
With Birch Truth. The one who will hunt.
The one who hunts. And how important is he? Just a single Geru just going to control your life, tell you what to do?
It's the Black Spiral, and you walked a similar path.
Find this Black Spiral, I'll fucking kill him like every other BSD I've ever met in my life.
Very well. You're gonna go. The conversation's over.
Yeah, you're gonna go. I'm not following you anywhere. You stabbed me in the back for some white girl pussy.
What did you say?
What'd she say to you? What'd she offer to suck your dick or something? You let that fucking slut run your life?
And you're gonna tell me who's the slut?
Just a fucking slut. Everything I've done, it's been for alpha behavior. It's never been about love. I don't love any of the hounds. I don't love a single man I've ever been with in my life.
Wolves born made like this. We made ones with the ones we love the most. Most of Red Blood and Talon Packs are families. Your alpha behavior is a common misconception.
And that's your issue with your wolf bullshit. We're not whole wolves either, just whereas we're not holy people. We're something else.
There's alpha behavior in that.
There's alpha behavior. Everything I do, it's for power. I'm strong because Gaia wants me to be powerful. I have sex because Gaia wants me to be powerful.
Autumn Leaves, roll me a wits and perception.
Understand. Wits and perception. Alertness, sorry. No, wait a minute. Perception maybe ain't something else because there are two attributes. And I'm confused.
Oh, yeah. You can't wits and perception, attributes. Difficulty 6. Oh, wait, no, yeah.
I cannot do that.
Oh, wait, really? No wits and
perception? Yeah, because they have both attributes.
Not wits and perception. Wits and primal urge, difficulty 6. Sorry, my fault. I keep getting those two mixed up. I gotta stop doing that.
Success.
In the middle of that argument, your nose twitches. You smell that. That's kind of throwing you off. Like, yeah, she's yelling at you right now, but something smells wrong around here. Like, you know that scent, but it smells wrong. What is that?
I'm gonna where this scent coming from?
It is coming from over this way, along the, or actually no, back down this way.
Which is the corner of the map? What? Wait a minute, I'm gonna zoom out a little bit.
Yeah, which corner?
Yep.
Yeah.
Over this way.
Bottom right.
Okay. Yep. I see it.
There's another rocky cliff over there, and you turn away from end of the road to catch that scent.
What is this? I can try to go there.
Make your way over there. It gets a little bit stronger. It's faint, but it's there. You swear to God you know that.
What the fuck is he doing?
And as you guys take off through the woods, we are going to go to another map where I'm going to have the rest of the pack is going to be over here with some of the Monongahela Valley Cairn. Bites the Head is going to be with you, as is Howls Through the Night and Dashes Upon the Rocks. And there's a handful of other Lupus. Jen and Siddharth, if you could place your tokens, please. All of the wolves are busy sniffing around, trying to look for clues, trying to see if there's anything that smells like the taint of the worm.
Is this where I parked my car?
Yeah, I'm gonna say that this is like down the trail a little bit. Your cars are right there, but I don't think I have them on me somewhere.
I got rid
of them, but like, you're near the road, but you're still a little bit ways off from it. This is like the more Hamid trail, but it's a relatively quiet day here at the park.
I gotcha. I need to find a couple of spirits later.
Yes, you do. I assume you're getting some gifts then, correct?
Get your mojo.
I'm debating Burrow and Sonic Shout right now, but I'm also want to get King of Beasts as well.
I see. Give me one second. I gotta get a, Actually, I'm gonna remove one of my rustic tokens here, just so I can get rid of that. Make some space. Okay. Sorry, I gotta upload some more shit just because, like, I don't have time for...
Got it.
I came in very ill-prepared to this session, mostly because, like, I've been moving and things have been hectic as shit.
You've torn up your entire house and then rebuilt it.
Yeah,
from the ground
it's
up.
It's been a journey, so that's gonna be there, and I also need one more, so that, and that one there, and I need to go get one more. Alright, there we go. Okay, so, that being said, you're all looking around. Everybody who wants to go by smell, please roll me a Perception and Primal Urge at difficulty 7. Actually, no, difficulty 6. The taint of the worm is very easy to smell. For those who want to go by sight, please roll Perception and Awareness at difficulty 6. Cleft, if you want to go by hearing, it's difficulty 7 due to your flaw.
I'm muted. It's difficulty 5 without scent. With scent. Sorry.
Mm-hmm. Difficulty... Oh, wait. You have keen scent. You have keen smelling, don't you?
No. I'm... So, the flaw increases it by 2.
Oh, by 2. So, yeah. For hearing something, it'd be difficulty 8 for...
Okay.
Actually, no. Yeah. For hearing something, difficulty 8. For seeing it, difficulty 7. For... catching the scent, difficulty 6.
Oh, I'm rolling a lot of ones today.
Yeah, you really are.
That's one success.
One success. Who would like to go by scent? Who would like to go by sight? Who would like to go by hearing?
I'm going by scent. I'm in lupus form.
Okay, by lupus form, that is going to be perception and primal urge at difficulty 6.
So I've got 3 successes.
Oh yeah, you did roll. Okay, so you got 3 successes. You smell something faint up over this way. Siddhartha, actually, would you like to do me a favor and roll? Let me check that real quick. Attributes. Do me a favor and roll wits and occult at difficulty 7. Actually, no, difficulty 6 is fine. There's a spirit lurking around here somewhere. Perhaps they might know something. There is a river here if you want to use a mirrored surface to step sideways.
Yeah, I'll do that.
Alright, roll me Gnosis difficulty 6 because you're technically out of the Cairn space.
See what you get.
So Gnosis difficulty 6, right?
Yes.
Give us something crazy, said it, Sid. Check this out. What are you thinking about? Anticipation.
It takes you a minute, but eventually you pass through to the Umbra. And they're in the Umbra with you. Walking around with an old shotgun on his shoulder is this human in the Umbra. But
kind of cock an eyebrow.
Upon closer inspection, though, he has a hole in his hat that seems to lead to nowhere and an eye patch on. Oh, wait, no. This is a wraith. Hello.
Oh. Hello.
That's you a big, mean-looking wolfie.
I don't try to look mean.
Well, you have to pardon me. I've seen a lot of wolves over here. They don't like me moving too close to their den.
Wow. And then is someone's home.
Yeah. My home used to be close to here. Till I went out hunting with a buddy, and now this is my home.
I see. Interesting. Have you seen anyone else around here?
I see a lot of folks wandering around here. Most recently, I saw this other couple around here. That was the other evening. And then I saw someone who looked familiar. He looked kind of like me. I thought he was my friend. And then I thought it was an accident, at least. I don't know what happened to my body. I would have figured he took it back to my family. But he was always the odd sort.
I see. What
was
his
name? Was this the guy who robbed me? Or tried to?
Well, I mean...
I'll just reuse that.
I'm not there.
You're not currently there.
Yeah, this is just Ryan.
Out of character, no. He does not look familiar. And he doesn't sound like him either. Well, he was a squaggly looking fella. He wore this long black coat and carried a rifle with him everywhere he went. Even to the store, which store owners didn't really like, but he always took it with him. It smelled kind of funny too.
Funny how?
You know when you had a bloody nose and it just dried up? It always smelled like that. I don't know how. Guess he always had bad nosebleeds.
Seems like an interesting character. Do you know where he went?
Last I saw, and that was a while ago, up over there a ways towards the highway.
Hey, interesting. Anything else funny happened these past couple days?
I saw a wolf cub walk through here a while ago. He didn't see me, I don't think.
A wolf cub? Where did he go?
He went back that way.
Alone?
Yeah. He looked a bit lost. Cleft, you would already know he's probably referring to the cub that was killed.
I mean, I can shift over there, but he's currently not there.
That's right. So it's just Sid talking to the ghost right now.
That was just Ryan making connections that weren't there.
Yeah, sorry.
Anyway, I'm going to be off my way.
Odd fellow. I'll step back.
Okay, go ahead and roll Gnosis difficulty 6 again. Alright, you are immediately back out of the Umbra. Cleft, would you like to roll either a Wits and Primal Urge or a Perception and Awareness? Wits and Primal Urge will be difficulty 6. Perception and Primal Urge... Sorry, I'm getting those...
Perception and Awareness.
Perception and Awareness will be at difficulty 7.
I'll do... Perception and Awareness.
Alright.
Where is it? You know what would help? If I put on my fucking glasses.
That might help a little bit.
What was the Awareness in this one?
Perception and Awareness is at difficulty 7.
I meant, like, because I don't see awareness as an option.
Sorry, alertness. I keep fucking that
alertness.
Up.
Alertness. Oh, okay. And difficulty 7. Ciao. 3.
Very far off in the distance towards the highway, you hear the distant rumbling of an engine. Sounds like somebody's racing rig down over there on the highway, but... You heard an engine like that not too long ago when you went out, you were picking up Siddhartha and Jennifer from karaoke. That was last night. Do me a favor, Cleft, and roll. I'm gonna say intelligence and drive at difficulty 8.
four successes.
Unmistakable. That is a 1979 Chevrolet Camaro, inline V8, about 220 horsepower. Definitely got a stage 2 exhaust on there. Wait a minute. That guy from the bar with the black hair and the sun, that couldn't possibly have been him, could it? No. What's he doing all the way out here down from Fairmont?
I'm going to start making my way over to my truck. Since we're farther away from the Karn, I'm also going to take the time to shift into Ahmed.
Yes. Jim, would you like to try and do a either a wits and primal urge at difficulty 6 or perception and awareness at difficulty 7?
I'll do the wits.
Okay. Oh yeah, with three successes. You definitely catch the scent of it up towards the highway. You think at first that it's just the highway, but it's a bit too distinct. It smells like somebody was here recently. Alright, and the rest of the wolves noticing you two are going to follow after. Oh, sorry, that's Siddhartha.
Grabbing the snub nose, putting it in my pants pocket, and grabbing my Ma and Pa. I'm going to keep that kind of hidden behind my leg as I walk.
Okay. Siddhartha, would you like to report what you have discovered with the Wraith to the rest of the party?
Yes, that's the first thing I'd do when I come back. I'd explain what the Wraith told me.
Okay, so the rest of the party, you know that there was a Wraith who was apparently shot in a hunting accident, quote-unquote, by a friend of his that smelled like a bloody nose and dressed in a long black cloak, who carried his rifle with him everywhere he went. Sounds like some sort of typical hillbilly behavior, but the scent of the blood catches you off guard.
Long black cloak doesn't sound very hillbilly to me.
No, it doesn't. Do me a favor and roll me, Actually, I'm going to do Wits and Enigmas at difficulty 7.
See what you get. Let's see you do this.
One success.
I got one.
So, in your history, you've heard of black spirals that, you know, like to wear all black in order to better venerate the forces of death and entropy. Seems a little bit too coincidental, but might be a lead worth following. So, as you two head up towards the highway, I will move back towards, I will move back to Forest Generic towards, I'm probably going to just keep it as Forest Generic 2 for Ends the Road and... Actually, no. I'll move you guys over to the first Forest Generic.
Whoa!
Yep.
Where the fuck we
these
going?
Guys can. These guys aren't here.
These guys can get out of here.
You two. I'm gonna move you two both over to this side because you're following. You're following Autumn Leafs right now, who's caught a scent. Autumn Leafs, do me a favor and roll me another. Wits and Primal Urge at difficulty. I think I said it was 7. I'm going to move down to 6 because you're getting closer to it.
Okay. Wits and Primal Urge, not Perception.
Oh, Wits and Primal Urge, yeah.
Difficulty 6.
Yep.
Ooh, what the fuck? Oh, nah. I'm going to use a good... I'm gonna try to restore my willpower because there is a different scene.
Yes, go ahead and roll it again. That was Wits and
Stamina. Wits and stamina and rituals.
Or stamina and rituals, difficulty 6.
This. Carl, I just got an email. I got my fucking bonus in the mail.
Okay. I'm gonna reroll those two. Once.
Right. Reroll two of the ones, please.
Let's see what you get.
Alright, so you reroll those ones, and that is going to be...
One success.
Yep, that is two success... Or, yeah, one success. It's still drifting in and out, but you know, but you swear to God you know that scent. And the ends, you have no idea what the hell he's after. First, you were arguing, and he's probably betrayed you, but what the hell does he smell? What the hell is going on?
Just storm after him. Just go and look at my hands, see how much of it I've destroyed.
Your hands are pretty bruised up right now, but they'll heal.
Yeah. Just wipe the blood off my forehead, flick it on the ground. See what the fuck you're doing.
And there's a bit of a rocky crag separating these two scents here. I'm going to say that's where this these leaves are. But on the other end of it, you spot a sinister-looking shadowy figure looming over the hills. Wait, I set that to map accidentally, I think. Hang on. Wait, did I set that to DM? Oh, no, I set it to token later. Autumn leaves. What the hell is that?
See, it's an asshole.
You hear, you see, and despite the distance, it looks over, it sees you, and smiles, and then vanishes over the horizon. I don't think this is the proper fucking music to be playing with this right now. Hang on, let me go ahead and change the mood a little bit. Wherever the hell my other
team. I don't know. I've got Kickstart My Heart playing.
Yes. Yeah, this whole Motley Crue playlist going in the background.
Yeah, give me 1 second.
All right. So what kind of tune you're gonna play?
No, I got it. Hang on.
Let's see. We can put some Master P in the background.
Hang on, let me
make
see.
Make him say,
Yeah, it's the Luscious Rap Snaps.
Okay. What will I try to do?
Well,
is to how?
Do me
I don't know.
You, after seeing that, I won't even say you have to roll with that. That had to be him. He was right there. He was right there, and he just disappeared over the horizon.
Okay. Autumn Lee's has a moment a little bit, just freezed in place.
Yes. Actually, I need some more tension music. Hang on. Let me see.
Just going through your brain. Anything about the sax?
Give me 1 sec, I gotta fucking get a different one. Can you track to the next one? Fucking
well,
really?
Hold, somebody's struggling with the music bot.
Yeah, I really am.
Yeah, try it one more time.
Alright, hang on.
Yeah, let's see this work. There it is.
There we go. That's the one I was looking for. That had to be him, though. So what are you gonna do? He just fucking vanished. He's over the horizon.
Yeah, I know. I have a moment when I saw it and he just left. Autumn Leaves shakes his head and howls for... Yeah, so I howl as hard as he can so that... every other lupus and as well as back knows in which direction to go.
Okay. Are you going to take off after him?
Yeah.
Okay. Go ahead and try and chase after him then.
Yeah. Come on.
Come on.
There's a spider out there. We're going to argue later.
Gonna roll my eyes as I just follow him, just crack my bruised knuckles back into place.
Alright.
What's in here?
I forgot to download the to download the fucking daytime version of this map, so just use
it's
your
fine.
Imagination.
Whoa, hallway.
Sorry.
See Highway Star.
Yeah, let me get rid of these for the time being.
We try waiting to hell, baby.
Yeah.
that. Is. And I gotta, I actually gotta get something from another map because I realize I'm on the wrong fucking map.
Play the mid-eye version of that song.
Not for this scene. Where the fuck did I put all my shit?
You're having the same issue I have with Red Cross Russia.
Yeah, I did. Well, that, and like I kept running out of space, and now the token that I had for that car is no longer there, so now I'm just gonna have to go ahead and put one of them on the map and then another one on the map.
Sean, what's the most delicious flavor of rep snack?
What?
The rep snacks.
No. I didn't eat either. Just in Hunter Games, in Sunday game, I just, you know, I was exposed to it, and it's like, why the fuck it was even made? It's just chips, and there's like on the box there's like face of rappers.
Yeah, it's crazy flavors too. Let's
see, like what?
You get sour cream and onion and barbecue all fused into one flavor.
Well, that's weird.
Yeah.
That's Gangsta Paradise. That's flavor, yeah?
Alright, actually, yeah. So, we're here on this page, and that's good. Sure. And so, here on this other scene... The fuck have you been? Get in the fucking car! Ends the road and autumn leaves. You get out right here.
That kind of milly little shit am I listening to?
Metroid Fusion?
Yeah. No, the voices.
Oh.
Voices! Yes.
Stop right here. Let's see.
Ends the road. You see the... Loop, or both of you see the loop is jump into the back of that yellow worm box as the gentleman here pulls down his sunglasses and reveals a wormish eye as he glares at you, ends the road, bites his lip, throws the car into drive, and floors it out of there.
That guy didn't look that bad. Just gonna go ahead, bend down, leap onto the road.
You see his tail light. You see the smoke from him in the distance as he peels off around the mountain. That's a damn fast car.
Fast enough to drive away. Stay in this town, you'll live and die this way.
Yep. That had to have been him. You gotta get after him. One way or another.
Look at this guy.
Good luck getting there on foot.
That man's a piece of fine milk chocolate. I'm gonna let that melt in my mouth before I bite down for the kill.
Ain't bad for a white boy.
Yeah. Okay. Thinking about that. I'm thinking about you know who from Canada. And I'm having a bit of a revelation. That everything I didn't have the time to do to him, I'll do to that guy in that yellow car.
Ends the road. Roll willpower, difficulty 8.
Let's see. Well, lick my lips while I'm thinking about this. Looking at this. Willpower. Difficulty 8, you say?
Yep. Add 1 rage.
Let's see, 1 rage.
He looked exactly like him. It wasn't exactly like him, but you could swear that smile was exactly the same. And as the smell of the Warrantine hangs in the air from his exhaust, you feel the thought start to creep in.
Mm-hmm.
And the monster that I left within you lingers. The scars on your mind that will never heal. It's there. And he's beckoning. What the hell's wrong with you? What do you want?
Autumn leaves, you're going to see the insta road like slowly trail her fingers up her chin, and she's going to bite the tips of her fingers.
Get off the road. Yeah. You're not going to catch them on the foot. Yeah. And pause.
I'm gliding the tip of my tongue across the tip of my middle finger while I look down at you. Did you say something?
Yes. Get off the road. You're still in crinus form. You're going to get bad.
I'm gonna turn around as if to say, like, what car? Like, what car is heading my way?
So far it's an empty highway along the side of the mountain. It doesn't look like there's anybody coming.
See, I'm not wearing pants, but I'm gonna do like a very exaggerated putting hands in my pockets kind of motion and just take my time getting off the street. Jump over the guardrail, land over here.
All right. Just as you jump over the guardrail, I'm going to say that having heard the howl, the rest of the pack, please enter from stage right.
Says you may jump inside.
Let me find.
Cleft comes out with his shotgun raised. Sees them and then puts it down.
Alright, let me.
I escaped. We must use the Weaver's box to catch them on. Maybe the Koroks can know a little bit more. He was that guy when we went to take Sidarta and Jane here. Yellow car. White man.
Cleft, that sounds like that 79 Chevrolet Camaro. Exactly the same one. He was just here. You just missed him.
Son of a bitch. They were there when I picked up Jen and Sidarta.
Yes, I was in passenger seats with you.
Oh, shit, you were. Yeah. Sorry. My brain.
I know Bonner brain.
It's
hard. Without the rest.
I don't think my truck can keep up with the Camaro, but try. As long as we get the scent, I'm going to turn around and start running toward the truck.
All right.
I'm surprisingly faster than I used to be.
Yes. Okay, so that being said, you guys are going to head back towards the truck then.
Mm-hmm.
I'm heading towards the truck, and then I'm going to pick him up on my way over. Back out.
Oh, okay. So if that's the case, you two are still there on the side of the road then, I think.
I don't know where Jen and Sidarta went.
Yep. I'm going to say that... Well, I was going to say, like, the whole pack probably heard that howl and sent everybody over.
Gotcha.
That's what I was trying to communicate, but I guess not.
The English language stinks.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes.
Aren't you doing this entire game in Polish?
There's only one of us who speaks Polish.
And I'm gonna left. And when he pulls German, I'm gonna left.
Weil ich denke, dass ich kann diesen Spieler auf Deutsch machen.
Ja, na widzę cię. Szczęśliw piekle.
Okay. So,
I can do that too.
Sidarta and Jen, you come through moments later just as the trails of the smoke are rising into the air, and you just miss them. But where would they have gone? Where would a black spiral go? I mean, do you really want to know where they are? Where that hive might be?
I don't think we have a choice. We need to find them.
Indeed you do. But catching up to them, that's going to be the hard part. Tracking them is easy. Catching them, a little bit more difficult. But you do know a very talented Theurge in Fairmont who might be able to help with that. And just as the thought crosses your mind, Cleft, that phone you stole from the Setite starts buzzing in your pocket.
I put on my best fake voice and I answer.
All right, put on your best fake Shane Kleinick voice despite never hearing him. That is going to be... Let me check something real quick. I mean, it's kind of hard for you to sit to hear what he sounded like because you only saw him for like a second, and then.
I've got his ID. I can figure it out.
Could you?
I got his ID. That's fine.
All right, so that is going to be manipulation and subterfuge at, or actually, no, manipulation and performance at difficulty 8.
Manipulation and performance.
You have to convince that whoever's on the phone that you are indeed Shane Kleinick, who you only met for a brief moment when you put a slug in his chest.
I'm only going to roll 2d10 because it's not even worth changing all that stuff. I'm going to roll that one.
Your voice cracked just as you answered the phone with a hello, and you immediately reverted back to your regular bone gnar speak. But whoever is on the other end of the line doesn't seem to care. Hey, motherfucker. Where the fuck have you been? I've been trying to fucking reach you for the past fucking night. Where the fuck are you at?
The last place I was at.
That's supposed to fucking mean something to me. That could mean a fucking meth lab in Fairmont. That could mean the fucking one in Morgantown. That could mean the one in fucking Charlotte. Where the fuck are you?
Writing that down for me. Where are we?
You're so high off your own fucking supply, you better not have run off with my money, punk. You understand how much that is? That was a lot of fucking meth that we sold you. You understand me? And now it's gone fucking missing. I ain't fucking heard shit from you for the past evening. You're supposed to give me nightly fucking updates. You understand me? There's a tight ship. And if I don't get what I need to fucking do, then a fucking big honcho down here in fucking Chattanooga is gonna fucking string me up for the top of a chantry. You understand me?
Yes.
Yeah, you better fucking understand. My whole fucking coterie gonna be there tomorrow fucking night. And I tell you what, if you don't get my fucking money or my fucking drugs ready or a good fucking excuse, you're all dead, motherfuckers. You understand me?
Hey, you know what? I don't need this shit. I'm gonna hang up.
It was the most satire answer he could ever give.
That it actually was. Give yourself a point aware of willpower for lying to a drug dealer.
Hey, a
vampire drug dealer.
Yes. So Clef, you know that there is now a coterie of vampires hunting you in Fairmont.
Not hunting me, hunting
Shane Kleinick. This might be an excellent opportunity for an ambush, but you have a bit more pressing matters right now with the Black Spirals, both of which right now are in Fairmont, which are north of you.
Yeah. Alright. That's got how to spell fucking coterie.
C-O-T-E-R-I-E.
C-O-T-E-R-I-E.
Yes.
I spelled that first try.
Yes. Jen, meanwhile, while Cleft is being screamed at on the other end of his phone, your beeper starts going off.
Okay, I will check the number.
You check the number. You actually do know that number. That is Riko Takeo. He is a glasswalker from the Sept of West Virginia University. Underground organization, Agaro, there trying to infiltrate Hamid spaces and get them to see the good ways of Mother Gaia and gain some kinfolk. People call him Rick, just as a nickname. He also manages your site where you sell your pictures.
Groovy. I'm going to pull up my trusty Nokia and phone the number back.
Hey, Jen, it's Rick.
Hi, Rick.
Oh, quick question. So, spring is right around the corner. Weather's starting to get warm. And I think it would be a great idea if we did ourselves a little photo shoot, bringing some extra revenue, if you're not busy.
I'm busy right this minute, but I shouldn't be busy in spring.
Well, it's April, so technically we are in the middle of spring.
Oh, so like in a week or so, that would probably be doable.
Whenever you get the time, and also just come visit, because also, big news, you just got 25,000 hits in the past 3 months, so that's pretty big, just saying.
That's a lot of hits.
Yeah, it is. They're buying your pictures left and right. They just can't get enough. We're going to get a lot of good kinfolk out of this.
That's good.
So, yeah, how you been? I haven't actually gotten to talk to you in forever. I'm sorry about that. I've been busy, you know, Hell Week. It's getting near close to finals. How have you been?
Pretty decent. I joined a pack, and I'm the alpha, and we're the playboys.
No fucking way. You're the fucking pack alpha, and you're calling yourself the fucking, oh my god. Wait till the fucking guys up here in West Virginia Uni, you wait till they fucking hear about this. They're not gonna fucking believe this. And also, you should totally come up sometime, because, trust me, I got some info you're gonna wanna fucking hear when you get up here. We've had a couple of fucking folks come around. There was like a job fair recently or some shit. We got some good info whenever you get the time, okay?
Okay, that sounds like a date.
All right, tight. I'll see you then. Take care, girl.
Okay, you too.
All right, bye. He's going to hang up.
Okay, I will also hang up my phone.
All right, cool. So, a couple of things we can do now. Black spirals, but very mobile black spirals. Talented Theurge, who might be able to give us a tune-up. Coterie and Fairmont waiting to try and kill us, or whoever they believe Shane Klanick to be. And a photo shoot opportunity and maybe more shit to do up in Morgantown. What say you, fellas?
Spoilers. When I get everyone in the car, I'm going to ask Jen if she can talk to... Hey, Jim, do you think you can get in touch with Fornator or Fornarrator in the gang? See if they can take care of that coterie or a coterie that's been hunting a guy I killed.
Maybe.
You do have both narrators and Arnie's numbers.
That's what his name is, Arnie.
Okay. I'm not driving, so I can phone.
Now, who would you like to call?
I'll go right to the source. I'll call poor narrator.
All right, the line rings. It rings again. Hello.
Hey, poor narrator.
Jen, what's up? How you doing?
We're looking for information on a coterie of vampires.
Coterie.
No, there's going to be a coterie of vampires heading toward the meth den that we busted up.
Oh, yeah, and they're associated with that meth den that we broke up the other night.
Oh, really? Did they say any names?
Any names?
I don't think so.
No,
we don't have any names.
Not a lot to go off of, but I
do know that they're gonna.
What's up?
I do know that they're gonna show up at either Morgantown, Charlotte, or Fairmont.
Morgantown, Charlotte, well, frickin' Charlotte.
They're most likely gonna show up at Fairmont first.
Show up at Fairmont. Well, yeah, that makes sense. That's where you guys threw the wrench in their whole thing. So. I'll phone up Arnie and tell him to keep a lookout. He said that they're going to be busy tonight because they got a lead on somebody that they think is working with somebody else. So I'll get to them as soon as I can, but, you know, the hounds, they're out doing whatever they will. But, yeah, I'll let them know, okay? Matter of fact, fuck it, I'll let everybody know. It's my fucking job, isn't it?
Okay.
Classic.
All right. Anyway, yeah, anything else you need me to do or just spread around some shit like I usually do?
That would be awesome.
All right, can do. Consider it done. All right, talk to you later. Bye-bye.
Sure.
All right.
Okay,
They want to hunt me? I'm going to hunt them right back.
All righty. Pack Alpha, you've got a couple of different objectives. What would you like to go for?
We're still on the trail of the Black Spiral Dancer, so I think that would be our quitting in the middle and running off to do something else doesn't seem
Well advised, gotcha.
All yeah, right. So...
So, if that is the case, I will say that you guys are back on the road in your cars then. I really should have fucking got a daytime fucking road, but I...
Don't worry too much about it.
So, I'll say that you guys made your way back to where you parked, said your goodbyes to the cairn of... What was it? Oh, yeah, the cairn of... The Monogalian Valley Sept.
I'm not giving these weakling shit.
Yeah, so I'll put you guys back on over there as you guys are getting back into the trucks there real quick. Back over to... Where is it? This one right here. I'll say for the sake of argument, your trucks are back on over there. Put the rest of the party back over here. Wherever you'd like to be. And Autumn Leafs, where are you at? There you are. House Through the Night is going to trot up to you and give you just a tender nuzzle.
I give it back the nuzzle.
I am sorry that you are not leading this pack, but I have faith in you.
Thank you. Stay strong.
I must, as must you. You find who did this, and you show them wrath that you have never shown before.
Yes. God, that I will do. If you as well.
She's going to nod and slowly trot back, still looking rather despondent of all she's been through, as dashes upon the rocks and bites the head of the worm. Sit waitingly as they await your departure.
Okay. Autumn Leaves, do you have a notion where end of the road might
she's
be?
She's on the how do you call it? Yeah. Bridge.
Just got stunned cross form, just leaning on the bridge, looking into the water.
Yeah, and still looking somewhat fucked up from punching a mountain.
Yeah.
Her hand's healed by this point. It's, you know, Garrow healing.
Yeah.
All right.
If you're looking at me, you see that I'm just going, you're seeing I'm making these facial expressions.
This is a certified Denji moment right here.
Yeah. Gripping the side of this with one hand, feeling my face with the other.
Okay, I'm going to let you keep doing that because you probably need to adjust.
Yes.
All right, so Jen, you've got Jennifer. Your truck. Cleft, you got your truck.
Jennifer, question.
Yeah.
Who's number two? After you.
I guess end of the road kind of came in second on those events, so that makes sense.
You saw him when he asked the question, tail was up and wiggling, but when you answered, it goes down and is motionless. Very well. I'm going to sit on Passenger's seat on Clive's trunk.
Yeah, I mean, we're not such a big pack that we require a lot of structure, I don't think.
Yes. Okay. You the alpha, you call the call.
Okay, that sounds good to me.
All right. And as you all mount up and get ready to head up to try and hunt down some black spirals, that is where we will conclude tonight's session.
All right.
I have been out of the saddle for a very long time, and I was woefully underprepared, but I did what I could.
Don't worry too much about this shit, because as long as you still have moments, as long as you still have entertaining stuff, it's fine.
Yeah, I'm going to say great. This. Players carried. Every single player carried.
Yeah. What did you say?
Oh, just start playing Johnny Cash.
The Nightcore version.
I'm gonna turn that down.
Smart choice.
It's fucking Sonic.
All right. So, if that is that. Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Well, Mr. Storyteller, how much XP do we get?
So, you did the trial for Pack Alpha. You did a little bit of tracking. Mm-hmm. Communicate with some spirits. So, I'm going to say for this, I'm going to give you 2 XP.
All right. Be a golden letter reaching down when the man comes around.
Yes.
I think I can purchase something.
This is the new one with the new audio setup, so I will get to hear how my fancy-ass new AT2040 sounds with my
We may or may not have to go into like YouTube editor and cut out some shit if it gets copy-striked.
Yeah, I'm going to have to do that, I guess.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I've got to finish installing DaVinci Resolve because I got the JSON file for it, but I need to fucking... I need to do something for it. I don't know what, though. Oh, yeah, I need to get it set up with my GPU. Anyway, that will be tearing it for tonight, fellas. Thank you very much for tuning in. And have yourself a
good damn it, I'm 1 point short.
Sorry.
Have a good night.
Good night, everybody.
Good night.
Take care and drink water.